turned into an, a complete animal. I turned into a disciplinary. This guy had me cleaning my room. He had me just, this guy brainwashed me so much that if he told me to, if he told me to bite, I'd bite. If he told me anything, I was like his dog. He broke me down. He broke me down and rebuilt me. I was just like a totally different person.
Mostly it just changed my life because he helped me to deal with people. I'm not to deal with people now. Before, I couldn't talk to people. I used to always want to be alone. And now I learned how to deal with anyone. I can talk to anyone, even if I have problems. It's like a father and son relationship. But even though he is my manager and trainer, sometimes I forget that because of the way we are. The first day he met me, he took me in his house. He didn't even know me.
I can say honestly, I have a very deep affection for him. I do. To me, he's my boss. He's with me. But I often say to him, you know, I owe you a lot. He doesn't know what I mean. I'm going to tell him now what I mean. If he weren't here, I probably wouldn't be alive. The fact that he is here and doing what he's doing and doing as well as he's doing and improving as he has gives me the motivation and interest to stay alive. Because I believe that a person dies when they no longer want to live. But I have a reason, Mike, and he gives me the motivation. I will stay alive, and I will watch you become a success. Because I will not leave until that happens.
I was 14 and for the Junior Olympics in 1980, I believe it was, and I broke all the records.
You tell me what you're going to do tomorrow.
I'm going to go in and jab to the head, then I'm going to go to your body, and then I'm going to move after I hit. I'm punching your body.
What are you going to do when you get inside?
I'm going to open up the side of the bench.
I wanted